So I'm excited to take over leadership at the Koch Institute because, you know, I firmly believe that the Koch Institute is one of the most amazing units at MIT and honestly, one of the greatest places to do research in the world. I would argue we created a new paradigm for how to do cancer research, bringing together scientists and engineers that really have been able to do incredible things. It was an experiment where we brought people who took very different approaches to solve problems in the world, bringing together of, you know, scientists who were focused on understanding the molecular basis of cancer with engineers who are really trained to go out and solve problems in the world. So where I see the Koch Institute heading in the future, you know, really is hard to predict because that is going to grow out of the amazing discoveries that come from our investigators within the Koch Institute. However, I can certainly speak to some directions that I think the Koch Institute needs to go in order to, you know, retain our place as one of the top cancer centers in the world. First of all, we have to continue to build on what we've done well in the past. Many of the modern understanding of cancer biology came from discoveries that came from investigators formerly in the MIT Center for Cancer Research and what is later grown into the Koch Institute. And then we built a model where we could really work together with the fantastic engineering colleagues at MIT to really realize how some of those discoveries could begin to be translated in order to help patients. And certainly we have to continue to do that, which means building on a foundation of discovery and always looking for what are the novel technologies and innovations to move the field forward in places where it hasn't been before. Now, there's also a couple new directions that clearly things are going and we need to be leaders in those directions given that we are at MIT. You know, there's been a revolution in, you know, computer science, machine learning, artificial intelligence. Those things, how best those are applied to make healthcare better, that's something that without question falls into the purview of what MIT and the Koch Institute needs to do well. And I plan to make sure that we move our institute in a way that we can realize the potential of those new technologies. So one unique perspective that I bring to the leadership of the Koch Institute is as someone who's trained as a medical oncologist and continues to see patients. And I intend to do that for a couple of reasons. First of all, because I firmly believe that there is value to having physician scientists, that is people who understand both medicine and research, in positions where they can help know what the real problems in the clinic are, so that the solutions that we find at the laboratory can most effectively be answering the right questions that are going to make the biggest difference for real people. I also think there's something about it that keeps me grounded, right? To go and see patients, see the reality of what people are experiencing when they're facing a cancer diagnosis. That is something that I think all of us need to keep in mind. And it's a perspective that I hope to bring back to my colleagues at the Koch Institute and hopefully both inspire them to, you know that these are real problems that we're trying to solve that help real people. But at the same time, hopefully inspire them that, you know, the work we are doing is making a difference. That perspective, I hope, will, you know, make me a more effective leader of the Koch Institute and also help our scientists accomplish our mission of really making the world a better place and easing the burden of cancer suffering. From my perspective, one of the things that makes the Koch Institute most special is the people who work there. We have an incredible mix of people, both across the trainees and the staff and the faculty, that are really as good at their jobs as anyone anywhere in the world. We have an amazing community of scientists and engineers, and I see tremendous potential for us to continue to work together in a way that will change the modern understanding of cancer biology and how cancer is treated and detected and how really we can move forward together and make a tremendous difference for patients.